Welcome to another technical video. Today we are going to the fourth part of our topic, isolator, switch and circuit breaker. In this session, we will be discussing about the graphical symbol that we are seeing on the equipment such as circuit breakers. When we are dealing with a circuit breaker or when we are buying it from a shop, we should understand what's the meaning or what we are going to buy. Actually, I understand even the suppliers or dealers or salesperson, they are not giving a clear idea to them who are buying it. So today we will be discussing in detail about the symbols, and if you are finding this useful, please share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel and support me. I request, if you have not yet seen the last parts of the topic, part 1, 2 and 3, please go through them in my YouTube channel. Okay, let us move to the topic. Okay, the topic is graphical symbols for use on equipments. Equipment means here I am dealing with a circuit breaker. The references, please note these references, some IS and some IEC standards I am using, then plus National Electrical Code 2011. And I am discussing about the graphical symbols for use on equipment. On the equipment alone I am taking, but the references I am quoting all the other section also. Means graphical symbols for diagrams and graphical symbols for use on equipment, but about the equipment only I am concentrating. Okay, now please see the pictures here. I will be explaining back what is represented by this symbol. You can see the larger part of the symbol here. See here another symbol, what's the meaning? Let us see. Here another one. See here also you can see, here the difference is the supply part is from the lower side. Means a line. Line is coming from the lower part. That's the difference. And here also you can see another symbol. Here the same. Here also a different one. Here the equipment is belonging to Havel's. And I think the Havel is showing the equipment in the reverse order. Means the line will be coming from the male part, means the female part. Female part means the lower part. Okay. Okay, let us go in deep. Here the symbol shown is a circle and it is representing switch function. It is a terminal having the function of a switch. References are also shown here. The next one is terminal of isolator and the next one is terminal of a circuit breaker, circuit breaker function. Okay, now the switch. Switch means it is just like this, means two round figures, and in the lower part or the male part, the instead of the round you can simply join, that is also there. So these three symbols are representing switch. Then isolator or disconnector, here you can see the symbols. Next is switch disconnector. Switch and disconnector are combined here, and please see the references there. Now simply a fuse, and then comes switch fuse, means combinations of fuse with switch or isolator or switch disconnector. So here three symbols of switch fuse are shown. It is disconnector fuse or isolator fuse, and here it is switch disconnector fuse. Okay, here it is fuse switch and then fuse disconnector or fuse isolator, then fuse switch disconnector. Fuse switch disconnector means supply flowing will be completed with the fuse firstly, then only the other part will be completed. So we call it as fuse switch disconnector. So the symbol is showing fuse switch disconnector. Now it is circuit breaker. Circuit breaker means just a cross line, cross. See here, cross. So any of these symbols represent a simple circuit breaker. But the next one is circuit breaker with isolation duty. Means in this symbol, in addition to the symbol in the top part, a horizontal line will be there, and the here it is clubbed. Means a cross is clubbed with the horizontal line and looking like a star there. Okay, it is representing circuit breaker with isolation duty. Now we are moving to the references based upon which I explained the 3-4 slides back. Okay, now National Electrical Code 2011, and there IEC 60617 is quoted, and it is representing switch, then isolator, fuse, and a circuit breaker. Here 12032 IS, and here we have taken this symbol cross representing circuit function, then isolator function, then switch disconnector part also. Then about it is representing circuit breaker. This is simply an isolator or disconnector and switch disconnector. Here both of these symbols are meaning for switch. Okay. So it is fuse switch, and the next one is fuse disconnector. You please note the difference. It is simply a switch, but here on additional horizontal line is there. So we call it as fuse disconnector. Here it is fuse switch disconnector. Fuse switch disconnector. Now it is circuit breaker with isolation duty, and please note this reference. Here it is simply a circuit breaker, and the reference is ISO 7000. Now, based upon 609473 part 3, you can see all these symbols again, which we already discussed. You can see the different symbols there. Now, as per 60947 part 1, this symbol is showing a circuit breaker suitable for isolation duty. Then about the same thing is explained here, and the reference to is 60947 part 2, and it is showing that it is suitable for isolation duty. Now what is the meaning of every symbol shown here? It is a switch disconnector, it is a circuit breaker with isolation duty. Okay, it is a circuit breaker without isolation duty. This one is also a circuit breaker with isolation duty. And here the two symbols, you can see a portion here with some shapes. It is representing thermal tripping, and the lower part is explaining about magnetic tripping. I will show some pictures for that. See, here it is a cross section of MCB. Here on bimetallic strip is shown, here on electromagnet is shown, or magnetic coil. This bimetallic strip is for overload protection, so we can call it as thermal tripping, and the other one is electromagnetic tripping or magnetic tripping, and it is for short circuit purpose, short circuit protection. So with this MCB we are having both protections, overload protection and a short circuit protection. It is an MCCB. The picture is little bit complicated, but I want to just show you this one, overcurrent tripping device. And bimetallic stripping arrangement is there. It is for overcurrent tripping or overload protection. So with MCB we have seen both tripping. here with this MCCB, only we can see on overcurrent tripping mechanism. Anyway, there are in most of the MCBs, both of the trippings are there for overload and short circuit. But in MCCB, I think we can get with either thermal tripping or magnetic tripping. Anyway, we will go in deep about this MCCB later. Here it is the cross section of an isolator. There is no electromagnetic tripping or thermal tripping. Without any such protection, it is simply an isolator. See here, it is representing thermal trip, and this symbol is also used, and this one is showing magnetic trip. So this one is a circuit breaker without isolation duty and having both tripping. Okay, the last one is circuit breaker with isolation duty and having both tripping. And you can see what is the meaning of this symbol. It is a four pole circuit breaker having isolation duty and both of the trippings. That's a meaning. So let us go back to the initial pictures that I told you to explain back. See here, the right side equipment is an MCCB, and what is the symbol here? It is a circuit breaker with isolation duty. Means this MCCB can be used as secondary protection breaker of a transformer up to 400 kVA rating. It is in Kerala, we are allowing MCCB as the secondary protection device instead of ACB. And the condition is it should have isolation duty. To the left side, what is it? It is an MCCB. Usually MCCB may have the protections, but here it is switch disconnector, SD, and the symbol. What is the meaning of this symbol? It is switch disconnector symbol. So this MCCB is a switch disconnector and it is not having any protections. So in a last video I told you about the requirement of an isolator in a fire pump circuit. So in such cases, instead of the conventional isolator, we can use this type of MCCB, means a switch disconnector having without any protections. It is simply a switch disconnector, means it can function as a switch as well as an isolator. Okay, now see here, in this picture it is a circuit breaker with isolation duty and having both trippings. Okay, see here, it is circuit breaker with isolation duty. Now what is this one? There is a conflict here, so I can't conclude what is exactly this equipment, that we have to refer the manufacturer. See, it is the symbol shown here. It is showing a switch, not even an isolator. So if it is an isolator, it should be like this. Horizontal line should be like there. And otherwise, there should be a symbol like this. Terminal should be like this. So if it is there, we can say it has a switch disconnector. See here, it is written like a switch disconnector. So as per the manufacturer, it is a switch disconnector, but as per the symbol, it is simply a switch. So I am leaving that part. See here, it is as per the symbol, it is a switch disconnector. The only difference is line is coming from the bottom part and the upper part is load side. That's the difference. Now with this symbol, it is a circuit breaker with isolation duty having both tripping. Okay, here it is a circuit breaker without isolation duty and having both tripping arrangements. Here it is a switch disconnector, and it is four pole switch disconnector. See, here it is again a symbol is that of a switch, but if it is a circuit breaker, the usual symbol is like this. I mean, there must be a cross, and if it is having a isolation function, we will be adding a horizontal line. But here this cross is not shown, so instead of this cross, the tripping curves are shown. So we can accept this, but I couldn't find such a reference in the references quoted, but we can accept, and it is written here as a miniature circuit breaker. So it is, this symbol is showing a circuit breaker, miniature circuit breaker having both tripping arrangements but without isolation duty. Okay, so by this I am concluding topic about graphical symbols. I understand that it is clear to you. So in future, don't be confused when you are purchasing a device, purchasing a circuit breaker. Please go through this video again and understand thoroughly the exact meaning of the symbols. And if you are finding this content, this information as useful, please share them with your friends, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Okay, then I'm leaving. Let us see in the next technical video. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you.